Welcome to the Fasting Podcast, Wow, Wellness and Optimal Weight. I'm your host, Julie Phillips, certified natural health professional, wellness educator, and coach. This is episode 62, Rebounding or Yo-Yo Dieting. If you know anyone or you personally experience the vicious cycle of losing weight, only to gain it back again, maybe multiple times, lose, regain, sometimes regaining more than what we lost. It can be a vicious cycle that's driven largely, perhaps, by toxicity. And we'll talk about different sources that we can get toxins in the body, but our fat is, in a way, trying to protect us and sequester these toxins away from our heart and vital organs. And yet, the fat is even more toxic because it can emit very many undesirable hormone and toxicity into the body that can affect our health and our weight. And when we lose weight and we're not aware of what's going on, we could be seeing the scale go down because we're losing water or muscle, which is not what we want to do. So if we're losing water and muscle, chances are very high we'll be gaining it right back. And weight loss without open bowels can cause a major buildup and blockage. So we might even think we're gaining weight. Weight loss without a healthy liver can further toxify the body. I'd like you to picture a person who's kind of heavy around the middle, maybe the waist and the hips, and then picture that there's a lot of toxins down there where the fat is sequestered in the toxins to protect our heart and vital organs. But if we lose weight without doing it the correct way and without eliminating toxins, now picture for a short time a very thinner looking body, but now the toxins could still be in there, but more concentrated and creeping up instead of just around our tummy, hips, and thighs, creeping up perhaps around the heart and vital organs. So what does the body do if we don't eliminate those toxins? Well, survival mode can trigger, let's gain some more fat back to protect us. And very importantly, our emotions can actually be toxic and cause regain as well, with emotional eating and being less positive than we need to be. So let's talk about a few ways we can gain toxicity in the body. That's the key problem in many cases with this rebounding. We can get toxins from our food and drink, innocently, chemicals, pesticides in grocery store food, restaurant food. It's amazing how toxic our air is, especially indoor air. So I did a previous podcast on how to purify air and surfaces in the house. Toxic water, done multiple episodes on water, but the plastic bottle waters are very extremely toxic because they're filling heated plastic without letting it properly cool. We also can get toxins in our body when we use regular off-the-shelf personal items like shampoo, conditioner, toothpaste. Things like that are chemical-based and are introduced and can go right into our skin even though we're not swallowing them, lotions, potions. And this is really toxic if people choose to use an antiperspirant. Now, we were designed to be able to get toxins out of the body under the underarms. So if we use a chemical-based antiperspirant and block up those holes, we're forcing the toxins to stay in there. And especially the females that use a wireframe bra, that is saying, let's not even let the lymphatic system move the toxins out of that fatty area where the breasts are. So now we've got the perfect storm for problems if we combine a chemical antiperspirant, which many of them have aluminum, by the way, with a wireframe bra situation. Speaking about the lymph, a lot of people are very stationary. They don't move enough. They aren't moving the lymph. The lymph is carrying toxins out of the body, but the lymph doesn't have a motor or a pump like the heart does. It has to be moved because we're moving. So whether we're walking, whether we're doing like a little mini trampoline, or some people like the little vibration machines, I actually have one of those and like it. Moving the lymph is really important. Insufficient hydration. People that aren't drinking enough water per day can really cause a very toxic system. And once again, the fat is, in a way, stepping in to help. But many people, partly because of insufficient hydration, have insufficient bowel movements. And we did a whole episode on that one. And if you're eating two or three meals per day, I'm hoping as a wellness coach, you're getting two or three large, brown, smooth bowel movements. But especially if you combine it with heartburn type challenge, so poor digestion combined with lack of bowel movements, this is creating an environment where toxicity can build and build and result in more fat to store those toxins. But I once presented in South Florida with a cardiologist who said, yes, Julie, in a way, fat could be functioning as our friend because it may be keeping some of the toxins away from our heart and vital organs more safely around our hips or tummy or thighs. However, it is not our friend in a large way because the fat is like an entire endocrine system by itself, and excess fat can emit over 30 substances, he said, only two of which the body finds useful. One of those, he said, promotes insulin resistance, and the other one that is key to note, he said, promotes the bad estrogen that can lead to tumor risk. So definitely we want to keep our river flowing and stay clean with great digestion, assimilation, and elimination. Poor diet and excess fat and toxins can even accumulate in the arteries and around the cells, so these poor, built-up, toxic little cells might have trouble pumping through the clogged arteries. So you see how these different parameters that you get reported when you go to the lab can be affected by the toxicity level in the body. Stressed liver also allows more toxin circulation into the body. So we want to keep a healthy liver is our friend. So let's talk about some things we can do. Well, right off the bat, probably one of the most important things is to switch over, if you're not already doing it, to eating super clean and drinking super clean, all natural, organic, whenever possible. I don't believe it's good to be an extreme fanatic about very many things. I think it's good to have some moderation. I think it's what you do most of the time that matters. Plentiful pure water, not the little plastic bottled water. And the very positive mind-body-spirit connection and support for that. So there's things you can do to help you stay positive and stay with the positive mind-body-spirit connection. The body composition scale is such a valuable tool. We did an episode on that. You can get it for less than $30 on Amazon. That'll tell you if you have visceral fat clinging to your vital organs, if your muscle percent is normal or below or above normal, and same for body fat. Another thing we can do is detoxify the colon, the liver, the lymph, and a candida cleanse. A lot of people have trouble losing weight or gaining it back because they have a problem with yeast overgrowth candida and possibly too many heavy metals, not just from amalgam fillings, but also because of creamers you may have used that had aluminum, pots and pans. There's so many ways. And when you have too much heavy metals in the body, it can make getting rid of candida extremely difficult. Definitely, you might want to look at a candida cleanse, as well as the colon, the liver, the lymph. Get the body moving. There's something called colonics or colon hydrotherapy, where expert massage people who are licensed, they use water in the colon with a speculum, and you actually can look at the clear colored tube and see the things that come out that maybe you hadn't eaten in years. Usually colon hydrotherapy takes multiple visits, usually at least three, and these massage therapists can massage the colon to get some of that built up hard stuff out of the system. And actually they've reported pounds of loss from doing a single session. Also, there's a really nice approach with oxygenating magnesium designed to put oxygen and alkalinity in the very dirty intestinal tract and slowly clean the sludge off the intestinal wall. and then maybe use a fiber to help soak up, like mop up or sponge up the toxins that come off. And that can eliminate a lot of the toxicity, as well as considering a combination of enzymes and probiotics in a single fell swoop. I actually like one that's in the same capsule. But doing this helps break down garbage and toxins in the system, uncovering protective coatings, and even exposing what is left, perhaps less what they call die-off, to the immune system and to the probiotics in the same mixture or taken at the same time. I also think that if you have a major problem with this rebounding or yo-yo dieting, that you also consider either a short-term 72-hour fast or a prolonged 5 to 15-day water fast. And if you're going to try to starve the body of poorly digested carbs, if you have a yeast overgrowth candida challenge, then multiple people have reported it taking 12 days or more to starve them to death with a water fast. So if you use these other tips that we talked about with the enzyme probiotic combination while you're doing the fast, this can help the body to get done quicker. Also, remember the body, if you're going to do a longer fast, can go into this autophagy to help recover and cleanse and rejuvenate the body, what I call Superman mode. So I strongly urge people to consider that and note the different warnings for certain people maybe shouldn't be fasting and with health problems should be checking with their doctor first. I definitely recommend increasing your activity for the lymph and for exercise, and developing and executing a plan to keep the weight off once you get it off. So remember that image we had in our mind of the toxic heavy person that had a big middle hips and thighs and there were toxins down there. But when they lost weight without eliminating toxins, they looked skinnier for a short time. But now the toxins might have been a lot more concentrated and even in the bloodstream. But now the concept is let's eliminate the toxicity and have a lot less toxins and be able to retain a slimmer look long term. And that includes the emotional component. So it's really important to develop and execute a plan to keep the weight off, something you can personally live with, which is very different than what the next person might decide is a good plan for them. Possible next steps, watch episode 17 on moving the body, lymph, and bowels, episode 22 on candida, and there's a little saliva test you could consider, episode 48 on the short-term 72-hour fast, and episode 61, the previous one, on the prolonged fast. We hope you refer others. Check out our website that includes the slides for each episode, our favorite Wow Natural products, a blog weekly, and the new Lifeboat Freedom video system. And that's at jpwowprograms.com. Direct questions or feedback to me, Julie, at jpwowprograms.com. Podcasters, we hope you give a written review on iTunes, and YouTubers, we hope you like the video and subscribe. Remember, stay positive, focused, and determined, because where the mind goes, energy flows.